So for today's video, I'm going to focus on a couple of scenarios where it makes or it makes no sense to hire someone as your interview coach or to use training, to use paid interview prep services, to be concise here. And these scenarios are according to my own experience. So what I'm telling you here is what worked and what did not throughout my career as an interview coach. And the first thing I'd like to talk about here is when someone is uncoachable. Okay, so believe it or not, there are people who cannot be coached, right? So for instance, as we grow younger, if you want, we tend to take feedback differently, right? So if you're someone who is not willing to take feedback from strangers or cannot take feedback from strangers easily, then chances are you might not be easily coachable. To give you a quick example here, I once got hired by a CEO and co-founder of a $30 million business. He had made recently an exit, and he was interviewing with a well-known company. And he hired me as their coach. We did a couple of coaching sessions, but we really felt like there was a disconnect. There was no really added value in his situation. And what happened is he sent me a thank you note 1 month after. Hey, thank you very much, Dan, for your help. I got the job. I didn't like your coaching sessions, but I loved the document that you sent me with the help for the interview prep. It was actually right now it's called the training program. But anyway, so long story short, people value things differently. So you should know very well what you're looking for. The second scenario I'd like to talk about here, where actually is the most common scenario where I've had success with as an interview coach, was when you are a busy person, you still have enough time to prepare for the interview, right? So you need someone to speed up the things and maybe keep you motivated throughout the process. You should be aware that this scenario is for people who can afford spending thousands of dollars for interview prep services. So, you know, to the extent that this makes sense for you, for your salary expectations, then this is something which might work for you. Also, interestingly here, some of my best clients that I had in coaching services, people whom I coached once a day for 2 weeks, or even twice a day in some cases, I wasn't their first interview coach, right? So it's perfectly possible your first experience with an interview coach will not be the best and you might have to hire a new coach. This is common. You should know that this is nothing new. So if you don't connect well with that person, then yes, maybe pick another one. Next scenario, the third scenario here, is when you're looking for a career change. Right, so you're not interviewing with anyone, you're still hired, but you think you might be looking for a career change. Then an interview coach, someone like me, might not be the best person to hire for this job. And the parallel I like to giving here is with doctors. Is when you get a flu, you go to a generalist, you know, equivalent of a career coach. They know more or less, you know, what could work in your specific case. Whereas if you are in need of a surgery on some specific part of the body, you will need someone specialized on that one thing and do that thing well, okay? Well, I'm more of a surgeon, you know, because I coach for behavioral interviews, you know? So the approach is slightly different here. So long story short, a career coach may also be an interview coach, but if you're looking for a career change, don't hire an interview coach, hire a career coach. Right, that's my best advice here. Next one, a scenario where I found that I could add value for someone is when they were looking for how to do their interview prep strategy. In other words, to strategize, hey, what's the best way to spend this time to prepare for my upcoming job interview? An example of this is when I helped someone applying for an engineering role, someone from the Middle East, and they took one session with me. I explained to him, hey, yes, you should do this, and that, and you could expect these types of outcomes based on your specific situation. And basically, that's it. And 6 months later, that person sent me a thank you note. Thank you very much for your help. I did actually land the job. Okay, so what you should understand from this is one thing, yes, it makes sense for someone to help you to understand what's the best way to prep for your upcoming interview and to set expectations for these things. And the second thing is this behavioral interviews, for instance, are hard work. You know, it might take 6 months to prepare these interviews, and some people do actually invest all this time to prepare them. And I can, of course, you know, this was a happy scenario, and I know many other happy endings of these things. But usually, if you are serious about these things, about behavioral interviews in particular, I can talk to my own expertise, it does pay off in the long run, right? Ideally, you should have multiple interviews around, but that's something for another time. But long story short, interview prep strategy advice works, okay? The next scenario, which hopefully will save many of you some money, is when you're 3 days or less before your intense interview with a high-performing company and you have not prepared for it. You can try all the coaches in the world. You can buy any training you want. I even know training programs for interviews if you're 2 days or less before your interview, because they know very well how to capitalize on this. I can tell you from going through hundreds of such cases, if not thousands by now, it never works. Okay, so don't spend your money on these things, because it won't work. If you're 3 days or less and you haven't actually prepared, it doesn't make sense to pay for job interviews prep. Next one, a scenario for which it works, and actually I didn't realize it was this effective, is when you're applying for an exceptional opportunity, you prepared, but you are slightly paranoid about these things and you want to go that extra mile to become even better at interviewing. An example I have here that comes to mind is from a director from Turkey who hired me as their interview coach. And I think in the second or third session, he actually was testing me. He was so good that he was testing to me on whether if I could spot they were reading their answers from their computer screen. So what you should take from this is that people go to extremes to pass these job interviews. And the second thing, you know, this is an example of cheating, but this person was this good. They had such a performant story bank that they could go, you know, that they could experiment with these things. So 95% of candidates don't even have a story bank. They can say they're proud of their thing. So in a context where you're applying for an exceptional opportunity and you prepared, yes, it still makes sense to hire someone for that extra level of precaution. And people do this all the time, quite successfully in my experience. Next one. If you're looking for someone to reward your answer or to learn English speaking skills, you do not need an interview coach. You need a linguist. Okay, and as an interview coach, I can tell you that I was amazed how well ChatGPT rewards interview answers. Maybe an idea for you to consider, but you don't need to hire someone, an interview coach or a career coach, to reward your answers for the purpose of job interview or to learn English. I don't believe in these things. What works, two scenarios in which coaching and interview prep and training programs as well work is when you are stuck in an interview prep process. What happens is this: when you build a story bank, that can be quite a lengthy process, as I exemplified, if you remember the 6 month behavior interview prep for that engineering role from the Middle East. With those 6 months, probably in the first 3 or 4 months, it's more like climbing a mountain with many ups and downs in your motivation. And it's up until you reach something which I call the critical chasm. You know, so once you reach that level of proficiency with behavioral interviews, you're happy with your story bank, then you actually feel empowered to interview. But if you don't reach that chasm, up until you reach that, you might feel quite discouraged and demotivated, and maybe you go on a false track, maybe you role play too much and your answers become too scripted instead of enriching your answers through writing stories. It can be many things, but long story short, if you get stuck during an interview prep and you don't really know how to get out of that thing and to streamline the process, maybe also a bit under pressure with time, then yes, it also makes sense to hire an interview coach. Yeah, and the other one was when someone gets rejected and they're looking to understand why they got rejected from their interview. So what you should know here is that in intense interviews, it's perfectly normal that immediately after that interview, you don't really understand how it actually went. For example, I once coached someone who sent me an email immediately after the interview telling me, hey, Dan, thank you very much for your help, but that's less than 0.1% chance they will hire me because they got me stuck, I don't know, three times during the process. They said it wasn't ideal. And then 1 week after, they got an email, they got hired and they got up-leveled, actually, right? So it's the result of an intense interview might not be straightforward to realize up until 1 week after your actual interview takes place. Because what happens here is that those interviewers got so smart that they ask you questions for which you have no idea why they asked you, unless you spend a number of hours thinking after the interview, hey, why would they ask me such things as part of their interview process? And what happens here, because there is so much tension, so much pressure, you might benefit from someone to explain you, to possibly help you as to why an interview went with certain questions and with certain follow-ups, especially for the purpose of behavioral interviews, especially for backbone tests, for deep dives, these sort of things. So this is when you unfortunately got rejected, but if you want to understand why they rejected you from these encounters, an interview coach can help you. Even if you give me the answer that you used, your story bank that you used, I could help you to give you some feedback. Hey, this might not have been ideal to say the way you said it. It wouldn't sell you on your strength and this sort of stuff. And I would just close by saying this. One of the dangers of interview prep and hiring someone to coach you for your upcoming interview is you'll get demoralized. And here, you know, the most extreme case is when you have a super sensitive person. And again, the anecdote with the doctors, a generalist, you know, might be someone easygoing person, but surgeon, they're straightforward. They know one thing and do it well. Same thing with coaches. If I know one thing and do it well, I might have come across some straightforward in some situations. So try to be upfront with these things, right? So hopefully you found this useful, and thank you very much for watching.